started shaking things up. That's how we know the Bible's true. A lot of you say that that book is tampered with. That ain't the word of God. Man wrote that book. That's how we know the Bible's real. The things that we're experiencing now is written in the Bible. But a lot of you want to follow man. But like our main objective is mainly to the so-called Negroes and Hispanics. You're the chosen people of God. And God wants you to wake up. The so-called white man and the white woman, you are ordained for a certain amount of time to rule over all nations. You were given a chance to follow God. But you ain't going to do that. You understand? Your forefathers ripped off, robbed, and stole, and God remembers it, God sees it, and you're going to be judged for it. The reason why the so-called black man, he's in the ghetto, because he's being punished for what his forefathers did more than 1,000 years ago. Yeah, you're laughing, but it's true. If you know the word of God, do you know the Bible?
Oh, yeah.
Then if you knew it, do you read that? Go open it. Don't put it up in your pocket. Go to the book of Revelations 13, 9 and 10. Revelations 13. We're going to read it while you go there. Go there. Get there real quick.
Get it.
You got the Bible on your shelves, in your car, in your pocket, in your pocketbook, but you don't read that book. And it's amazing. But guess what? Your leaders read this book. Your top leaders that are intellectuals into the Bible, they know what this Bible's talking about, and they hide this truth that the so-called blacks are the real Jews, and justice has not prevailed for the so-called Negroes and Hispanics, but it's going to come to pass. Hold on, read it. Where you at? Revelations 13, 9 and 10.
Revelations 13, 9 and 10. If any man have an ear...
Don't walk down the block. Where you going? Read along with us. Read it again.
If any man have an ear...
If any man has an ear, come on.
Let him hear.
Hear the word of God. Come on.
He that leadeth into captivity...
The Lord said, if any man leads another man into captivity, go ahead.
Shall go into captivity.
That same man, that same nation, they're going to go into slavery. Your people led our people into slavery. So according to God, you must go into slavery. Let's read on.
He that kills with the sword...
He that kills with the sword, come on.
Must be killed with the sword.
Must be killed with the sword. So that's God's judgment. If you believe in God, you know your Bible, the Lord ain't slack to forget that. The Lord said that must come to pass. The book of Proverbs 19, verse 21. The Lord said if another man leads another man to slavery, he must go into slavery. You understand? And a lot of the so-called Negroes and Hispanics, you get offended when we bring out stuff like that. That's the word of God. But when you go to church, they teach you just all the love aspects of God. He's all love. That's a lie. God is not all love. Who do you think is bringing the storms and the tidal waves and earthquake on the wicked people on this earth? God. Who do you think is making the economy act the way it's acting? God. Who do you think put the black man and black woman in slavery? God. So when you're bad, God gets you. When you're good, God blesses you. We were bad, so God punished us. Now the so-called white man and white woman, they're bad. They're gonna go into slavery just like you went into slavery. That's in the Holy Bible. Hold on, read it.
Proverbs 19:21. There are many devices in a man's heart.
Your heart is your mind when you read the Bible, or your thought patterns. But also there are many devices or ideals, because man is an idealist outside of God today. So also there are many ideals in a man's heart. Come on.
Nevertheless,
even though you might have your way of doing things, the Lord said, nevertheless, come on.
The counsel of the Lord, that shall stand.
The counsel of God is the Bible. That's what's going to stand. Romans 3 and 3. According to the Bible, the counsel of God, that's what's going to stand. So you still reading that, my man? Look up here. So the Lord said, the counsel of God, that's what's going to stand. We were brought in captivity by our enemies, our same enemies, they're going into slavery according to biblical prophecy. No, it's not hard to figure out. That's what the Bible says. Read that. Romans 3 verse 3.
Romans 3 verse 3. For what if some did not believe?
The Lord said, for what if some did not believe? Because you got a lot of people that ain't going to believe. You know why? Because the devil is in them. The devil, the spirit of Satan is a lot of people. Yeah, there is. Be proud of it. You ought to hear the devil. Be proud of it. But the Lord ain't the Lord. There's a God. Do you believe in God?
Absolutely.
So then why don't you do the things that God requires of you?
Absolutely.
Why don't you do the things that God requires of you?
You love all men. You need to tell your people to lay off the so-called black man.
Give us a break. You understand? Be righteous toward our people. You understand? Go to the book of Galatians instead. Galatians 6 verse 7. The Lord is real. You understand? And the Bible is real. And the God is going to come and he's going to deliver us, deliver the so-called black man and black woman along with the Hispanics out of captivity, brother. Remember that. Read your Bible and believe the Bible. Read that.
Galatians 6 and 7. Be not deceived.
Lord said, be not deceived. You got a lot of deceived people in America.